Hi, I'm Sarah, and welcome to Rich Textures Crochet on YouTube. Let's crochet something beautiful today. Hello everyone, I'm Sarah of Rich Textures Crochet, and today we are going to learn how to crochet a faux popcorn stitch. And that's the stitch that you see in front of you here. You can see that it has a great texture, and it's called a faux popcorn because it kind of creates this popcorn look, but it's quite simply made with single crochet and triple crochet stitches. So that's the stitch we are going to work on today. While you're here, please be sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel and grab a hook and some yarn, and let's crochet together. So today for the faux popcorn stitch, we are going to start with a slip knot, and we are going to need a foundation chain with an even number of stitches, so it can be any even number. Today I'm going to start by making a chain of 20 stitches. There's 10, 15, 20. As I mentioned at the start, this stitch pattern is simply made up of single crochet stitches and triple stitches. So what we are going to do is, working in the second chain from our hook, count in one, the second chain from your hook, you're going to work one single crochet stitch. In the next chain, you will work a triple stitch. So yarn over twice, insert your hook in the next chain, yarn over and pull up a loop. You'll have four loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through two loops, yarn over and pull through two more, and yarn over and pull through the final two loops. In the next chain, you're going to work a single crochet. So all the way down your starting chain, you are now going to repeat that. Triple crochet in the next stitch, followed by a single crochet in the next. Triple, and a single. And what you're going to see happening is that you are going to have your triple stitches, because they're quite a bit longer than your single crochet stitches, they're going to be kind of folded over there in the back, giving you that faux popcorn, the start of that faux popcorn texture. So triple crochet in the next stitch, single crochet in the next stitch, all the way across your starting chain until you come to the last chain, and you'll work your final single crochet in that chain, and then get ready to turn your work. I'm working my final single crochet there in my row. So this is what my work looks like from the back. Now when I turn it around, you're going to see those triple crochet stitches that have been kind of pushed out by the single crochets on the other side. So once you hit your end of your row, you're going to chain one and turn. You are now going to work a single crochet stitch in each stitch all the way across. So a single crochet in each single crochet stitch and triple stitch all the way across your work. And this is because when you come back, you'll start working some more of that texture. But if you didn't work your the single crochet row, then your stitches would be on the opposite side. So you want to make sure that you do this return row following each of your single crochet and triple crochet rows. At the end of your row two, you're going to chain one and turn your work. We're now going to work another row of single crochet and alternating triple crochet stitches, but we want them to be staggered in between the ones down below. So before, where we started with one single crochet followed by a triple, this third row we're going to start with two single crochet stitches. So a single crochet in the first stitch a single crochet in the second stitch, and now we will work our first triple stitch. Single crochet in the next stitch, and triple crochet in the next. You're going to repeat that all the way across to your final two stitches, where you will work one single crochet stitch in each of the last two single crochet stitches. At the end of row three, you're going to chain one and turn your work. Now, if you take a look at the front of your work, you can see that you have those textured triple crochet stitches sticking out there, and they should be placed relatively in between the ones in the row below. For row four, you're going to, after you chain one and you've turned your work, you're going to simply single crochet in each stitch all the way across. At the end of row four, you're going to chain one and turn your work, and there you have it. So now all you're going to do for the rest of your piece of fabric, for however long you would like, is you're simply going to repeat those rows one through to four until you choose to stop. So you'll remember that row one was a single crochet in the first stitch, followed by a triple stitch, and that will get you going again, having your faux popcorn stitches alternating between the ones down below. So thank you so much for joining me for this quick stitch tutorial on how to crochet the faux popcorn stitch. Until next time, happy crocheting. Bye!